before I have the pleasure of introducing Gerry Quinn, who's going to tell you all about a rotter ring. Since Gerry isn't a lawyer, he probably doesn't know all of the facts about our rotter ring. But this is where, first of all, I'd like to recognize and thank one of Justice O'Donnell's colleagues, Justice Kennedy, for joining us tonight. I should tell you, nothing happens in the Ohio Supreme Court without the concurrence of the Irish Americans on the bench, because we have four of them, including the Chief Justice. Gerry, I will now turn it over to you. You can see if you can do better keeping them quiet than me.
Hello there, how are you? Welcome. Welcome to the Mayo Society of Cleveland Annual Ball. We're delighted you're here, and I know you're going to stay very quiet because this is the most important part of the evening. You're going to meet our honoree, but first, you have to be patient and listen to me. God help you. You know, one of the most important and rewarding aspects of being the president of the Mayo Society of Cleveland is handing out the Mayo Person of the Year Award. As you know, we bestow this honor on a person in this community who has achieved great success in their private and public life. But before I introduce this year's honoree, a few sincere thank yous are in order. First, to all of you for attending this evening, the officers, the executive board, the members, and all of our wonderful, generous sponsors. Our visitors from Ireland, Mayo County Council, Eckley, Blacksod, Belmullet, Development, National University of Ireland Galway Foundation, and of course our Mayo Society from New York City. Now the program book, which I hope you will take home and treasure like you have done with all the other program books. This is the 11th one. Somebody told me tonight they have all those program books in their possession. To our financial supporters, they're listed in the book also, and all our visitors from out of town. So read the book. I should add here that we do fund, you've heard it already tonight, but we can't say it often enough. We do fund a scholarship program with John Carroll University and the National University of Ireland Galway, and the students are here with us this evening. I hope you get a chance to meet them. I know Dr. David Kleinberg is here with his table and the students. We also have a close affiliation with the Irish American Archive Society, and its executive director, Margaret Lynch, is with us also this evening. You know, they preserve the history of the Irish in Cleveland on a daily basis. And just I want to mention, the first Mayo Society was founded in New York City in 1879. And we continue that work here today in Cleveland, Ohio. The County Mayo of today is much different than the Mayo when so many of your parents and grandparents left there. It is now a prosperous and progressive region that all of us are proud to call the home of our forefathers. We are also very confident that our organization will continue to fulfill our mission of charitable giving and contributing to a culture that is admired throughout the world. Our Mayo Society Person of the Year is one person who has contributed greatly to that culture. A native Clevelander, he grew up in St. Mark's Parish on the west side. He attended St. Edward High School in Lakewood, Kent State University, and Cleveland Marshall Law School. A former school teacher, he is a founding member and past president of the Legal Eagles, a law fraternity for St. Edward's High School. He's been honored by every school and university he has attended. The one I attended sure wouldn't honor me, I know that for sure. He is the recipient of the American Jurisprudence Award from the American ORT Cleveland Chapter and a member of the Irish Legal 100, a group of prominent Irish lawyers and judges selected from across the country. Now he serves on the Supreme Court of the state of Ohio. He began his judicial career in 2003, and since then he has led statewide efforts to increase professionalism among lawyers and judges across Ohio. His leadership resulted in the culmination of a lawyer-to-lawyer mentoring program that is recognized nationally as one of the finest in the United States.